Hi everyone, Kiki Halbert here. I'm here to show you a quick tag using Scrappin' with Flair's September kit. I'll also be using a few things for my stash if I get the chance, so just to let you know that some of the items that you'll see might not be included in the kit, but they are available at scrappinwithflair.com. So I thought what I would do today is make a quick tag to show you how pretty this collection is in terms of being able to throw something together very quickly for a quick gift or a gift tag. And this would make a great idea as well for tucking in a little gift card if you wanted to have something unique to give to a friend. So let's start with what I've got on the table here. I have some of the items that I have from the collection, from the kit from Scrappin' with Flair. And this month it features Graphic 45's A Lady's Diary. And A Lady's Diary features a lot of these beautiful vintage ladies in different really stylish outfits. So I thought what I would do is use a couple of these. I've actually used them in a mini album that I've already created. And I thought I might incorporate some of these images on the tag. It also comes with this beautiful chipboard, the chipboard tags, so I'm probably going to use some of those. But what I've done so far, I know that I'm definitely going to use this lady. She's so pretty. And I've created a tag just using some chipboard at home from a box. And I'm going to cover that using this pretty paper from Graphic 45. You'll see on this side it's a lovely pink polka dot, and it's lovely and distressed looking already, and on the other side there's teacups. So I think I'm probably going to use both, so I'm going to cover both sides of the tag, and I'm probably going to use the side that I'm going to use for this lady will probably be the nice polka dot, just as a contrast, because I think this is probably too busy and she'll just get lost on this particular side. So I'm going to use the side on the back. So what I'm going to do first and foremost is I'm going to start with my quick dry adhesive. I love using Fabri-Tac or the Helmers. It works really well. So what I'm going to do first off is I'm going to put some glue down on my tag, just around the edges and a little bit in the center. Okay, just to get a good contact with the paper. Okay. So, I'm going to put that down onto the opposite side so I can get the polka dot on the front first. Okay. And you'll see too that my tag didn't cut quite straight on the bottom, but that's okay because I have an idea for how I'm going to take care of that. So, use a firm hand to push it down, or if you have one, use a brayer, and that will ensure that you get a flat, even contact so that your paper won't lift up again. So I'm going to do that. And all I'm going to do for this is I'm going to use some scissors just to cut around the edges. I'm going to rough those up as it is anyhow, so I'm not too concerned about just little bits and edges that are hanging over. I'm just going to do this very quickly, and it's going to have a shabby chic effect anyhow. So I'm just going to cut that straight across there, cut off the corner, careful not to cut the tag, and I won't worry about that because that's straight along the bottom, but that's okay. Now you'll see that I've got a hole, so I'm just going to use a hole punch and just punch the hole right through for my tag and try to get some extra edges there, get it a little bit bigger. There we go. Okay. So we've got that done. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover the back side as well. So again, what you may want to do for this side, because it's got a little bit of that glossy shine to it, is I may want to rough it up a bit just so that the glue has something really to adhere to. And so now I'm just going to do the same thing on this side. Get the glue started here. There we go. Get close to the edges, but not too close, because you don't want your glue squirting out the sides. Okay, and there we go. So that works. And now I'm going to flip it onto this side because I want that lovely teacup paper. Okay, so just going to even put this down evenly here. You'll see too that I always work with a craft mat most times, and that's just so that anything sticky can come up quickly from my projects. This one happens to be one of the Ranger craft papers or craft mats. Okay, so I'm just, again, I'm just rough cutting this because when I'm done, I'm going to sand the edges anyhow. And I'll show you why. So there we go. And again, want to punch the hole. This is why I punched the hole on the first side so I can see where I was going. And just going to punch the hole on the second side there. There we go. So now we've got that lovely teacup paper on one side and the polka dot paper on the other. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use my Prima tool and I'm just going to sand the edges roughly. And then once they're sanded so that they meet up with the tag, this is just to kind of take the edges off that I left behind from my scissors. And I'm not going to rough this up too much on the end, but you'll see how, if you can see that, there's a little bit of extra paper longer than the tag, so just sanding it off. Okay. And that will come off later. And then sand the other side as well, just to give it a trim there. Just to give it that shabbiness. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to ink the edges. And I'm going to ink this, I think, in vintage photo because the graphics on the Graphic 45 journals, ladies' diary, excuse me, are actually very kind of tea stained with the pink. So I'm going to use that. So I'll probably use the vintage photo then. So I'm just going to grab my vintage photo. And I have the distress stain. I find it the easiest way to go, and it gives me a good, gives me a really good inking on the edge of a tag. And because it's in a dauber format here, it usually gets right to the chipboard if there's any chipboard showing afterwards. Not too concerned about the bottom again because that's going to be covered up by some lace. But this is just going to give me a nice shabby look for it. Go. So just ink the edges quickly, and that's how easy it is with the distress stains. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I had planned on using some of this beautiful lace that comes with the kit and just edging the bottom there just so that the eyelet falls just off the edge. Okay, now I've cut it on purpose so that the scallop comes right to the edge of the tag, okay, so you can see that, and that way I've still got this little bit of lace covering over. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put some Fabri-Tac glue or some Helmars on the edge there, along the top as well, so I want a good contact at the top, and a little bit around the sides as well, okay, and I'm just going to dab some in different areas just so I can get some good contact with the tag. Okay, and I'm not too worried about the shabbiness of it on top. That's going to be primarily covered with flowers. Okay, so I'm just going to push that down there, get that contact there, and then I'm just going to fold that over and get the edge on the other side. Okay, there we go. Okay, so there's the eyelet lace that's on our photo, or on our tag. Now, this lovely lady is quite large, you can see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck her in, if I can, let's see. I might have her just come off the edge just a bit, like so, just for some interest. Okay, You'll see that the other side is a really pretty paper as well. So, all right, so I'm just going to put her, I think, right about there. Okay, so I'm just going to put some of the glue down again. I'm going to do this a bit willy-nilly, not too precise. And because it's Helmer's, it's repositionable, which is great. And I'll just stick her down there. So I just use glue because I want a really good contact for her on that page, on that paper, and on the lace. So I'm just going to push this down with the brayer. There we go. Okay, so we have the starts of our tag. And isn't that pretty? All right, now I have a variety of the additional items like I showed. I have one that's a pretty a very vintage car. I have some circle punch outs from another paper, which I may use up here just as a pretty accent. So I'm going to set those aside because I may use those. But I think what I'm going to do is I have one of these pretty pink ladies. It's a pink chipboard. Okay. So what I may do is I may use her, but I'm going to start by layering down some flowers because I love to have flowers kind of layered down on the bottom here. So I have a gardenia that I got. This is an I Am Roses gardenia from Scrappin' with Flair that I had got. So I'm going to use this one here. I'm going to use a pretty white flower from I Am Roses as well, and a nice brown flower. And then the kit also comes with some of these lovely vintage buttons. So I'm going to tuck those in there, but I'm not quite sure where yet. And I have a leaf. I also have some small tags that came with the kit, just as little accent pieces. So I'm just going to put those down. Not fuss too much about them. I like to start with the larger flowers first, so I think I'm going to put that sort of in that direction there, maybe with the brown and the white, maybe the brown over there, the white there. I might have our lovely pink lady over here, and then maybe, let's see now. Or I may put the pink lady, lovely pink lady up here, and tuck this little black tag down there. And I think that would look pretty. Now, one of the things I have in my stash as well is just some gold lace. And so what I may do is I may use this around here as well to tie. I may use it at the top. I'm not quite sure, but I do have some of this vintage crocheted lace. So I may use that. But for now, I think I like the flower placement. So I'm just going to go ahead with placing my flower down. Give it a good amount of that fabric tack or Helmer's, whichever you prefer. I haven't really found a difference with them myself, but I know some of my friends quite like the Helmer's over the fabric tack, so if you have it available, you can try that out. Okay. And Scrappin' with Flair also has a variety of adhesives in store as well, so you can certainly ask Leanne what her preference is. So I'm just going to pull this little, I like this little wire part there, so I'm just going to hold those down a little just to make sure that they get a good contact and hold. Okay. And they reposition a little, and that's okay. Okay, and then on this side as well, there's another viney part here, so I think I'm going to twist a little vine up there maybe. And put a nice dollop of this glue on here as well. Okay. And I'm just going to reposition it right about there. This one needs a little bit more glue. So I'm probably going to sneak it right in there, just like so. So I'm just going to hold that down for a sec. You'll see that it's got contact now. Should. And this one here, I'm just going to give it a bit more on the edges, just so that it can hold with those other flowers. Okay. And that's going to just position right there. Okay, there we go. Alright, so they're holding. They're holding. Are they holding? Maybe not. Hang on. I'm just going to give it a good dollop back there. And just hold that down. Because it's a liquid glue, sometimes it needs a little bit more encouragement to really set up. There we go, now it's set. Okay, so that's taken a little bit there. Now, you'll see that I've repositioned this rose over here. So what I'm going to do to kind of fill in this space is I'm going to tuck in that little tag right there. And I just need maybe a little touch of Helmer's right here. And we'll consider that probably pretty good. That's going to tuck in just underneath, just like so. And there we go. So there's that pretty place there. I'm going to put our little lady where I thought I would, up on the top. So I'm just going to put her off like so. Just let her set a bit. Okay, now I do have this pretty leaf, but the little leaves are showing on the gardenia and the roses, so I'm just going to leave that as is. And I'm just going to think about maybe tucking in one of these pretty buttons. Maybe just tucking it under, just as a little accent piece, maybe right there. We'll see. I'd love to have a little bit of glitz on this. Ooh, that looks kind of nice there too. Maybe tucked into the roses right in there. So I'm just going to, you see it's still got its edge there, so that's okay, because it will make contact with the flowers and with the paper as well. Okay, so I'm just going to turn this around just so I can get a better tuck in there. Okay, so I'm just going to tuck that in there and hold that there. I don't want it being too prominent, but I do want it showing up. So I'm just going to hold that a sec, and that should give it a good hold. Yeah, it's starting to set, so that's good. Okay. Now, I just want to take another quick look at it and see if there's anything else that I'd like to add to it. Up here, I think I'm definitely going to work with this vintage lace now, and just so I have a little tag tie. And I have this cute little number 45 button. So what I may do is just cluster it on here, or maybe put it on top of her little flower there, but maybe with something to give it a little edge. Just gonna sit that back there a bit. There we go. Okay. Well, at this point, now I'm thinking that I may want it somewhere else. Maybe tucked in here. That would be kind of cute. Tucked in. Yeah, let's do that. I'm just gonna tuck it in there just for some more dimension. See if it'll hold on to the wire there. There we go. And it's holding onto the wire, so that's good. The glue's holding. So that gives us another little added bit of dimension. And just to finish up, I don't think I want too much more on here, because I think I want the lady to really sort of stand out a bit more. So I think that's good. What I may do, what may look sweet is just some additional flowers or something along the edge here. So I'm just going to look in my stash and see if I can find something pretty. Here we go. So what I have here is a spray that I have from Graphics 45, but I don't want to use the whole spray, I don't think. That would just be overpowering. But I love how the little gardenia just continues there, so I may use that. But then again, I don't think I will. I think what I'm going to do in terms of accents is you'll see that I'm going to spray this with some Glimmer Mist. And I'm just going to give it a little bit of shabbiness, a little bit more shabbiness. So I'm just going to squirt my layout here, or my tag. It's a miniature layout, really. Okay, so I have some vintage pink. This is Cherub Pink, excuse me. Cherub Pink Glimmer Mist. And I'm just going to spray just over there. Okay, so that didn't go too far, but just to give it a little bit of a shot of pink and just a touch of the suede. This is the goldy suede color. I'm just going to give it a little spray just to give it a little bit of brown. There we go. Okay, and I just need to dab this up with a paper towel. Don't throw away those paper towels. You can use them again. Okay, so there we go. I've got a little bit of spray now. I've got some interest with my flowers. I'm just going to dab off this gem of a button. There we go. And it's given some interest. And now I'm just going to tie my tag in, or my ribbon here. I'll go from, I can never remember which side to go from in order to get the neatest bow, but I'm just going to poke it through there and then feed it through this part here. Comme ça. There we go. Just give it a little, see, I should have come out the other side. Live and learn. And I'm learning all the time with scrapbooking, believe me. It's never been sort of my thing. I've always been into more art journaling, but I'm definitely having so much fun working with paints and papers and scrapbook layouts. And there we go. So I'll get the little loop open there. Throw in the little lace ends. And the crochet will fray a little, and that, I like that look. I don't know about you guys, but I just find it gives it more of that real vintage appeal. There we go. So a little bit of a tag tie at the top with the vintage. And there we go. We have our finished tag. Very three-dimensional, as you'll see. It's got little touches of pink, little bits of spray there just to highlight and bring out some of the colors and bring out some browns as well. So we've got our peaches and our pinks and our browns, and now we have a lovely tag that we can give to a friend. Now remember, I said you can get a gift tag or a gift card and give it to someone, and that wouldn't be difficult to do because you do have quite a bit of dimension there, and you could just sort of tuck it in there to give as a gift. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and go out and get the kit from scrappinwithflair.com. It's definitely a beautiful kit that you just can't miss this time around, because it just has too many beautiful pieces that you can play with. So I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please let me know on my blog. Also visit scrappinwithflair.ning.com, which is the Ning site where you can participate with the design team and the owner of the store, and post your photos so that we can show your photos some love too. So thanks very much, and have a great weekend.